Fish passage and migration are critical to survival of native fish. Freshwater and saltwater species move at different times to access food and shelter to avoid predators and breed.
Obstructions to fish passage, like dams, weirs, floodgates, and waterway crossings, can have a negative impact on native fish. This can restrict the migration of fish and isolate populations. The Fisheries Management Act 1994 includes provisions to ensure the maintenance and restoration of fish passage as part of the construction of new or the modification of existing in-stream structures. A New South Wales Department of Primary Industries Fisheries permit must be obtained if proposed works could or are likely to obstruct fish passage. Department of Primary Industries Fisheries, also known as DPI Fisheries, assesses proposals based on the type and class of the waterway, which are referred to within the DPI Fisheries Policy and Guidelines document available on our website. Some other common structures that may obstruct fish passage include installing temporary structures such as piling pads, side access tracks and some erosion and sediment control devices. Works in New South Wales waterways can have major impacts on fish life cycles. Even a small barrier can deny fish access to tens or hundreds of kilometres of river. For example, before this bridge was built, the waterway crossing was a low-level causeway with two pipes. The flow of water through these pipes was too fast for fish to swim against, creating a barrier to fish moving upstream. Of all waterway crossings, bridges generally have the least impact on fish passage and are the recommended waterway crossing structure. Bridges also require less long-term maintenance compared to culverts and causeways. There have been many advancements in the design and construction of waterway crossings. Contact your local DPI fisheries manager to discuss options available. It is important to maintain culverts to prevent flooding and erosion, maintain the integrity of the structure, and ensure debris and sediment does not prevent fish passage. Causeways are usually low cost, near-level waterway crossings constructed at or slightly above the natural bed level of the watercourse, and some have a low-flow pipe. These structures are particularly poor at allowing fish passage and are generally not supported as they can impede fish passage during low flows. Fines up to $220,000 and remediation orders to repair and restore the habitat and fish passage may apply. Discuss your waterway crossing or in-stream structure proposal with your DPI Fisheries Manager early to inform the design of works for fish passage.
DPI Fisheries can provide you with advice and clarification on permitting. For more information, please visit our website.